Alright folks, today we're grilling this amazing looking chicken bell pepper pan. And this is so delicious. So stay tuned. It's time to grill. Alright, let's get started with cutting the veggies. Of course, for a bell pepper pan, guess what? You need bell pepper. Here is how I cut my bell pepper. Of course, I've speeded this up a little bit for you. Otherwise, cutting veggies might be very, very boring. We are doing this with a red one, with a yellow one, and with an orange one. Beside that, you will need onions. This one yellow onion peeled, cut in half, and then into rings. Garlic, of course, which is a must-have in most of my recipes. Chop it, and bacon. Everything tastes better with bacon. Same with today's chicken sauce. It's amazing how good bacon works. And of course, you will need chicken. These are chicken breasts. We only need the bigger part of the chicken breast. The other pieces go into a different video. I guess you have already seen that video, but it doesn't really matter. Take your favorite barbecue rub and season your chicken with barbecue rub. Coat it almost everywhere. Works sometimes good, sometimes not. We are grilling on the Weber Kepler charcoal grill today. The charcoal kettle is started with a starting chimney full of charcoal into the baskets. At the grates, heat it up and start with a cast iron pan for making the bell pepper sauce. It's still cold. We are adding the bacon and let that heat up. This might take some minutes, but all in all we have time. In the meantime, you can easily open up a bottle of beer or something. It's fun. As soon as the bacon fat starts to render out, add the onions, and of course I have also added the garlic. Sometimes there are people complaining about, oh, your pan is too hot, the garlic might burn. I can handle that. If you want to add some more flavor, add a dash of olive oil. This is a garlic flavored olive oil. It adds additional garlic flavor. Give it a good mix. Let it sit again some minutes there, and then you will need to add ivar. It's a paprika paste. There are different paprika pastes available, and then your bell pepper. Give everything a good mix, and again, we have still high heat. Keep going. We are adding a sweet balsamic vinegar for that recipe today, and a huge dash of white wine, which is the basic part of the stock for that sauce. Of course, you can do chicken stock or duck stock or beef stock or veggie stock here. I like white wine better because it adds a certain amount of acid, which is good for your flavor. Then season with the same barbecue rub that you used for the chicken. Barbecue rub is a great weapon. It has a lot of ingredients in there, mostly sugar, salt, pepper, and a lot of other things depending on the rub you're using. And it always helps seasoning that sauces. One can of diced tomatoes. A final mix. And then switch the pan over to indirect heat. Now it's time to throw on those two pieces of chicken breasts. And we are grilling this on the high heat, which is not as high as in the beginning. We have kept going for between 20 minutes or 25 minutes for the sauce. Grill it 4 minutes per side approximately. It really has a nice color now. I like that. Some great grill marks here. Lots of flavor going on. In the meantime, make sure not to burn the cast iron pan if it's not 100% over indirect heat. And after 4 minutes of grilling it per side, we are throwing these chicken breasts back into the pan, cover it with sauce, and then we let it grill on indirect heat with a closed lid for another 25 minutes. I gave them a flip in the meantime, I didn't film that. So here's the result. Yeah, I'm really happy with the result. Stunning. Look at the colors. Amazing. Okay, some close-ups for you guys, and as always, of course, I'm gonna give this a shot right now. Please make sure to hit that like button, leave me a comment. If you haven't subscribed yet and you are convinced now, make sure to hit that subscribe button. You won't miss any other video. You will get recommendations. It's completely free but not useless. We're seeing us again in the upcoming days. We have a lot of more content to come, I promise. Don't forget to visit my fan pages. 0815BBQ is on almost any platform. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.